We've been a leader in banking for more than 100 years. You'll find us here, at home, on your phone, and everywhere you go. Renaissance Bank. Understanding you. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Sponsored by Renaissance Bank.
Good morning and welcome to Newsbreak for Monday, December 4th. I'm Derek Russell. First on today's show, we'll take a look at the weather underground forecast. Today will be partly cloudy with a high of 70 and a low of 54. Your three-day outlook, rain in the forecast for Tuesday, 100% chance. High of 58 and a low of 33. Cooler temperatures after that. Wednesday, partly cloudy with a high of 53 and a low of 32. And Thursday, partly cloudy with a high of 52 and a low of 26. For more weather, visit djournal.com/weather. Our top stories for today, leaders at North Mississippi Health Services see positive signs for 2018. That comes after struggling through a rocky fiscal year in 2017. Since January 1st, the Tupelo-based system has received $1 million a month less than anticipated from Blue Cross Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's also seen reductions from Medicare and Medicaid. But the budget for the new fiscal year anticipates lower reimbursements and aims to return the system to a higher operating margin. The new plan includes eliminating contract labor and replacing those positions with permanent employees, among other factors. In August, the system's Tupelo Hospital announced it was closing its skilled nursing unit and its community health department. It also scaled back its inpatient mental health center. That was done with a goal to achieve $31 million in annual savings. And Chief Financial Officer Sharon Noble said the system returned to profitability during the first month of the new fiscal year. Chief Executive Officer Shane Spee said that despite the changes, the system remains focused on quality and safety. Mississippi Governor Phil Bryant and legislative leaders are recommending significant cuts to the budget that funds the State Department of Education. That comes at a time when the State Board of Education and Superintendent Carrie Wright are asking for more money. Their request is for extra funding for early childhood education, literacy efforts, and high school innovations. Those are all efforts that have previously been embraced by the legislature. The 14-member Legislative Budget Committee proposed for the general education budget to be cut by 3.9% or $6.6 million for the upcoming fiscal year. That committee includes Lieutenant Governor Tate Reeves and House Speaker Philip Gunn. Bryant is opposing deeper cuts of $10 million. The Department of Education is charged with providing oversight of local school districts to ensure they are following the laws passed by the legislature. Its budget also funds various programs passed by the legislature, such as literacy coaches and administrator training programs. MDE spokeswoman Patrice Guilfoy said the cuts would severely hinder the department's reform work to improve education. The city of Tupelo has turned its attention to improving a pair of annexed areas. The 2012 expansion of Tupelo's boundaries brought Prairie Cove and Frog Meadow Lane into the city. They're both located among Tupelo's western edge, and Councilman Mike Bryan has called them among the worst-kept roads in the city. Both roads will be totally rebuilt. Prairie Cove is expected to be completed in the next several weeks if there are no weather delays. Public Works Director Chuck Williams said the contractor will completely remove the existing asphalt and start from scratch. After Prairie Cove is complete, Frog Meadow Lane will receive extensive repairs. Public Works has been working to bring annexed areas up to the city standards. They recently completed paving of Deer Park Road and Whaley Road. Next year, Wesley Cove and Fern Ridge Road are slated for paving. And in sports, West Point High School defeated Hattiesburg on Saturday night to win the Class 5A state title. The Green Wave won 41-15 at Oxford's Vaught-Hemingway Stadium. West Point's Marcus Murphy saved the best game of his senior season for his last. The Mississippi State commit had 307 offensive yards and 4 touchdowns as West Point finished the season with 15 wins and no losses. The Green Wave has won 28 games in a row and back-to-back state titles. Fellow West Point running back Chris Calvert ran for 103 yards and 2 scores, and West Point's defensive shut down Hattiesburg's top-rated offense. Meanwhile, Starkville fell short in the Class 6A championship game. The Yellow Jackets fell to Pearl 21-17 on Friday night. That does it for Newsbreak on this Monday. Don't forget, this show is one of the many online offerings courtesy of the Daily Journal that gets you news off the page and on the go. Today at 2 p.m., you can watch the Capitol View webcast with Capitol Bureau Chief Bobby Harrison, where he talks about the latest taking place in state politics. Each story discussed today on Newsbreak can be found in your Daily Journal or online at djournal.com, where you can find a new episode of Newsbreak each weekday at 7 a.m. I'm Derek Russell. Thanks for joining us.